Tonight, a CNN exclusive source is saying President Trump had a contentious phone call with Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau over tariffs on Canadian steel and aluminum. And Trudeau pressed the president on how he could justify the tariffs as a national security issue. In response, the president said to him, "Didn't you guys burn down the White House?" Referring incorrectly, by the way, to what happened during the War of 1812. So let's bring in now CNN senior economics analyst Stephen Moore, who was a former economic advisor to the Trump campaign, and also CNN global affairs analyst Max Booth, the author of The Road Not Taken. Gentlemen, good evening. So Max, of course, that was the British. It is a basic knowledge of U.S. history, something the president should have, right?
Well, you would think so, but there are a lot of things the president doesn't know, including the fact that the nation of Canada did not actually exist in 1812 when the White House was burned.
That short. I didn't expect you to be that short and concise. I mean, Steve, even you laughed at that. What do you think?
I think he got confused. It was obviously the British who burned down the White House in 1812. It was a gaffe.
Okay. I was going to say, how would that justify tariffs anyway, especially considering, because it people say that the United States,
I'm totally against this. I think Trump is making a big mistake. Canada's our closest ally in the world, by far.
Our military partner.
In every way. Yeah. And so it makes no sense to be picking a fight with Canada or Mexico, for that matter. And look, you and I have talked a lot about this. I'm in favor of getting very tough with China, because I think China is a problem. But if you want to do that, you don't want to pick a fight with your allies. You want to have a unified front against them.
Did we just hear Stephen Moore say that the administration did something wrong, the president?
That must be a first.
I know.
But by the way, Donald Trump knew from the very start when, you know, I started working for him that I didn't agree with him on tariffs. I'm a free trade guy. Yeah. I respect the fact that he says, you know, we'll respectfully disagree on that issue. And I'm not going to, you know, change my positions and my principles because I favor Donald Trump.
Max, what did you want to say?
I think this is going to be a first, Don, where Steve and I wind up agreeing with one another. And I have to applaud Steve for his intellectual integrity. For not defending the indefensible, which is the fact that Donald Trump is calling our closest allies threats to American national security. And I think that rankles as much as the fact that he is imposing tariffs. I mean, the steel tariffs alone, by one estimate, are going to cost 40,000 jobs in the U.S. auto industry alone. But even leaving aside the economics of it, the symbolism is so damaging. And I watched on TV this past weekend the Canadian foreign minister and prime minister, and the sense of hurt in their voices was just palpable because, I mean, today is the 74th anniversary of D-Day when Canadian and American troops landed side by side in Normandy. We have fought with the Canadians for more than a century. They are our brothers and sisters. And to label them as a national security threat, just the sense of shock and anger in Europe, not just in Canada, but the same thing with our closest allies in Europe. I mean, this is such a cockamamie thing to claim that they are a threat to our security.
Yeah. But the Washington Post is reporting that Trump he's not too happy about his upcoming trip to Canada on Friday. And this is a quote. It says that the president has vented privately about Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau as their trade tensions have spilled into public view. He has mused about finding new ways to punish the United States' northern neighbor in recent days, frustrated with the country's retaliatory trade moves, adding that he's complained to aides about spending 2 days in Canada for a summit of world leaders. He believes it's a distraction from the upcoming Singapore trip. What do you think about that, Steve?
So, look, Donald Trump made a big point during the campaign. I think he called NAFTA the worst trade deal history. Now, again, I disagree with them on that, but this is something he made a big deal about in the campaign, that he was going to renegotiate NAFTA. And I do, look, it's been 25 years. It's been a good, I think NAFTA's been a good thing, but it does need to be modernized. Now, Canada, in my opinion, Max, does not get away scot-free here. In these negotiations, they're bringing up things like our right to work laws here in the United States. They bring up things like climate change, transgender issues, and so on that have nothing to do with the trade deal. And so, you know,
Donald Trump is the big impediment to a deal here. And the latest from the White House is they're floating the idea of giving up on NAFTA and negotiating separately with Canada and Mexico, which I think would be a huge failure of this so-called master negotiator, President Trump. But, you know, to me, the fascinating thing to watch in this upcoming G7 summit this weekend in Canada is the dynamics between Trump and his fellow Democratic leaders. I'm willing to bet that he's going to have better dynamics with Kim Jong-un, the leader of one of the most vicious dictatorships in the world, next week than he's going to have with his fellow Democratic leaders this weekend. because the G7 is now the G6 versus one, because the other six are allied or against the United States because of these terrible tariffs.
Well, let me defend the president on this. I am for free trade, as you know, Max. But you know, I was looking at the tariffs that other countries in Europe are charging the United States versus what we impose on them, and their tariffs are 2 to 3 times higher than we are. What Donald Trump is saying, and he's said this many times, I want to use these tariffs as leverage to get to fair trade, where these countries are lowering their tariffs. Now, if we can get that outcome, you know, what is wrong with that, Max? I mean, do we want the Europeans to be imposing high tariffs on American products?
You know, Steve, there is no evidence whatsoever that Donald Trump has had any success in negotiating any new deals. He's great at breaking deals. He's broken a lot of deals, from the Paris Climate Accord to the Trans-Pacific Partnership to the Iran nuclear deal. He has had no success in negotiating new deals. The NAFTA negotiations are stalled. It's not even clear what he wants from the Europeans. There's not actually an actual negotiation going on there. You know, he's fixated on the idea that any kind of trade deficit is a ripoff of the United States, which, as an economist, you know that's not true. That is not true. There's nothing inherently wrong with running a trade deficit. But Donald Trump is obsessed with this, which just goes to show that he doesn't understand the first thing about economics.
At the end of the day, you may be right that he doesn't have
deals. I've got to end this because I've got to get some
breaking news. But it's the third inning of a baseball game.
Thank you both. Thank you both. Okay. We'll see you next time. Listen, I do have some breaking news that I need to report to you right now, and it's about the battle over the so-called informant in the Trump campaign, a claim that has been debunked, including by senior Republicans who attended the recent briefing with the Justice Department. Here's what a senior Justice Department official tonight says, that the department will be extending an offer to the Gang of Eight to review certain documents that were made available during its prior briefing on May 24th to the same group, as well as a briefing on certain questions specifically raised by the speaker and other members. The official said that the briefing is expected on Monday or Tuesday, depending on members' schedules. And CNN will be on top of that story, and we're going to bring you all the very latest details on them as we get them. That is the breaking news. We will be right back.